Welcome to journal writing for today. I wanted to just give you a couple more instructions as to how to complete this assignment. You guys have been doing an awesome job with your writing so far. I just wanted to give you a few tips on how to stay organized in your writing and how to set it up on a notebook. First things first, when you're doing your journal assignments, it is best to use paper that has lines on it. If you have paper at home that looks like this, that has the lines on it, this is what I would recommend using. If you don't have a notebook or anything like this at home, feel free to use a blank piece of printer paper, but I recommend this the most. At the beginning of the school year, I sent home little red notebooks for our word work or spelling practice. That would be a perfect place to write your journal entries. So for our journal entries, if you decide not to type, you want to handwrite your journal entries, this is the type of paper I recommend. When you are doing a new journal entry, you need to put your name at the top and your number, just like we practice at school, right? This isn't any different online. And then on the other side, you're going to put the date. The reason the date is so important is because we're going to be doing a lot of these journal entries. And for me to stay organized and to give you grades and to see which entry is which, you need to make sure you've got your name and the date on it. And these squiggle lines here, obviously you're not going to just write squiggle lines on your paper, but what I wanted to show you is that when we're writing, we start on one side of the paper and we write all the way across using really good spacing. Once we've made it to the end, then we can move on to the other side. I see lots of us writing sideways or crooked or writing a couple words and then skipping some lines and writing some more words. What we want to be doing when we're doing our journal writing is writing on the line and then skipping a line, writing on the next line and then skipping the line. You can see here that you'll write on one line, skip a line, write on another line, skip a line, write on another line, skip a line. And this is going to give you room to fix any mistakes that you make. And if your handwriting is really, really big, you're going to try and squeeze it down onto those lines, just like we practice in school. Because in third grade, you're not going to have the big handwriting paper. So if you have handwriting paper at home, that's awesome. You can use that. If you don't have handwriting paper at home, please use lined paper. If you don't have lined paper at home, then you can use the blank sheets of paper at home. Anyways, I just wanted to give you those tips on how to do our journal writing to make it easier for me to read and to make sure you're getting good practice, that you're not just writing random stuff, right? So you guys are doing an awesome job. Keep up the hard work. If you have any questions, please let me know.